Hi guys, there's CJ Reviews here with another Mcfarlane Assassin's Creed figure review. Today we're going to take a look at Edward Kenway from Assassin's Creed 4. Comes from the same game as the previous figure I reviewed, which was Black Bart. Alright, let's take a look at him in the packaging first. Again, you got the this new Assassin's Creed Mcfarlane packaging. I really like it. Smaller, doesn't take as much room. Fully showcases the figure and his accessories. Assassin's Creed 8 Plus, Ubisoft. See the downloadable content you get. Assassin's Creed 4, an image of him right there. Another image of him. Edward Kenway has the Assassin logo there. Your Edward figure unlocks the Kenway family swords, so that's cool. Actually get something a little useful. And this shows the other figures here. You got the other two Kenways, Connor and Haytham. And you got the other two versions of Connor. And you got the figure there, and you've got the three pirates. I have reviewed Black Bart, so you go check that out if you haven't already. And yeah, that's pretty much it for the packaging. So it looks like a really cool figure. I'm going to get this guy opened up though. We'll see if Edward lives up to expectations. Alright, now we got Edward out of the packaging, and he is pretty cool. I do like him. He is a cool character in the game, and he is a cool figure. Let's take a closer look at him. So here we go. Take a look at the head sculpt first. Pretty good likeness, not exact on, but you know, it catches it, so it's pretty cool. You got the little beard goatee thing going on. The hood's very nice, very nicely detailed. You got a little blue part right there. Pretty cool. On the arms there, you got, in the shoulders and such, you got armor on there. Some leather armor or something like that. You got some blues and the dirty whites going on. He has some loose straps, like this little strap's a loose piece, and so is that, so that's pretty cool. Got a little skull logo right there. You got the red sash that all the assassin characters seem to have, and you got the little thing flowing right there. Got a few pouches right there, which is very cool. I almost thought that was a... You got a little sash things right there, a bunch of little straps. Got the blue there, which looks really nice. And then you got some like generic pants there and some generic boots here. But it looks very good. It's a good representation of the figure. I mean, of the character, rather. Very cool. As far as articulation goes, he's good. He has ball-jointed neck. And I will add, his articulation is quite tighter. It's way tighter than my Black Bart's articulation. But he has a... ball joint in the head, ball hinge shoulders, ball hinge elbows, ball hinge wrists, swivel at the, I forgot to mention, swivel at the forearm right there. Torso articulation is a swivel, at least. It might be ball joint, but I'm not getting any up and down motion, so I'm going to say it's a swivel. His ball joint in the hips, though, it's very hindered because of the robing, because it's not as pliable plastic as Black Bart's jacket was, so it's quite harder, and it's harder to get the articulation going. Got a ball joint in the knees, and you got a hinge at the... Let me see this. Yeah, you got a hinge at the ankle with the rocker joint, so that's pretty cool. Black Bart didn't have that, but he had the turning motion. Pretty good articulation. As for accessories goes, they're good, but he's also missing some stuff. Like, the only problem with this figure is that he did not come with any guns. He came with no guns and not really anywhere to put them. In all the trailers and all the... in the gameplay... you get the guns pretty quickly, and in the trailer he's packing four pistols, two on his strapped on his chest and two like on his sides. He doesn't come with any pistols. This figure doesn't come with any pistols. That sort of sucks. I would have liked him to have some pistols. That was one of the main parts of his kind of image, was having all those guns on him. It looked really cool. Unfortunately, we didn't get that with this figure. It kind of sucks, but I can live with it, I guess. It does, however, come with two of the Kenway family swords right here. Very cool. Put that down. It's got some brown paint on the handle, and it has an eagle there with the assassin logo, which is really cool. Little handguard there. Looks really nice, actually. Really nice sword. You get two of those. You can grip them both very well. And the next thing he comes with is he comes with two of these kind of sheathed hidden blades, which is very nicely detailed. They got the skull there. It looks really nice. And then he also got two of the extended ones. As you can see, I got the unextended one right there, and I got the extended one right there, which is really cool. They actually use just peg and hole system. I'll show you here real quick, if I can. This, he has two holes underneath each of his arms, and there's two pegs on the hidden blade, and all you do is just peg that in. And there you go, he's packing some hidden blades. And the only other kind of suckish thing is he doesn't come with anywhere to really store his swords. I kind of maybe see one spot, but other than that, kind of sucks. I might actually see if that works. Oh, so it does. And it doesn't even warp the sword too much. I guess if you really want to, it doesn't even look terrible. There's a little spot right there with a strap. You can actually store one of the swords right there if you want to. It doesn't look too bad either, to be honest. Ugh. Other than that, though, it's not really anywhere as you can really put it, which it's not like it would have been that hard for them to do, to be honest with you. I mean, if you want to, I guess you could sash it there, but that looks kind of retarded, so we're not gonna do that. But one other feature he has, which is the coolest feature and selling point for me, is that his hood is not glued onto his head. It's removable. Here's the hood, it's just a plastic. Flexi plastic, and that's a really cool. Not even NECA figures had that feature. You had to buy the figure, another completely another figure to get a unhood version. Now we'll take a look at the head sculpt. Get this one out of the way. There you go, and there you get a way better look at the head sculpt. It is pretty good. I really do like it. Looks good. Hair is nice. The only inaccuracy is he has a ponytail, but they couldn't do. I'm willing to sacrifice the ponytail for a removal hood, so I don't have to buy another figure. That's pretty cool. I like that. And it was also maybe at the cost of maybe being able to make the shroud effect, but the hood looks pretty good on him. Like, and even in the trailer stuff, you could still see there wasn't a whole lot of shrouding going on. It looks pretty good. It's a good looking figure, and I love that feature that you can do that, and you have a lot of different ways to display him. Anyways, overall, you're into this line, you're in the Assassin's Creed. I think this is a must have. He's just great. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.